Hello viewers, welcome to our program. In today's class, we shall discuss a poem titled Uphill, written by Christina Rossetti. Christina Georgina Rossetti was recognized as a major Victorian poet and as the greatest women poet in the 19th century. Uphill is an allegorical poem in which the poet has dealt with the theme of death, life, and life after death. In this poem, she offers a simple and laudable philosophy according to which everyone will get rest posthumously in proportion to one's earthly labor. Before we discuss this poem in detail, let us know about the importance of Victorian period. Victorian poetry was an important period in the history of poetry, providing the link between the Romantic movement and the modernist movement of the 20th century. Victorian poetry is a self-defining poetry written during the period of Queen Victoria's reign, that is from 1837 to 1901. It can be classified as early, mid and late. These three phases saw the progress in poetic sensibility from the Romantic era to the modernist era. Victorian poetry resembles the works of the Romantics, Romantic writers such as William Blake, Keats, William Wordsworth and Shelley. They had an immense impact on the Victorian poets. These two periods have a lot in common: skepticism, interest in everything mysterious, and distrust of organized religion. The leading poets during the Victorian period were Alfred Lord Tennyson, Robert Browning, Elizabeth Browning, and Matthew Arnold. The poetry of this period was heavily influenced by the Romantics, but also branched off its own directions. The development and the use of dramatic monologue gained momentum. It was a form used by many poets in this period, but perfected by Browning. The Victorian era was marked by the emergence of female poets. They could create an impressive space for themselves in the world dominated by men. In the early 19th century, writing was still seen as a prominently male preserve. There were few female poets before, as poetry was considered to be predominantly male occupation. The works of such poets as Elizabeth Browning, Christina Rossetti, and the Bronte sisters became famous during the Victorian age. The Bronte sisters were perhaps better known for their romantic novels, but their poetry, especially those of Emily Bronte, has received more critical acclaim in recent years. Many have suggested that her works were a reflection of the difficulties women of that period faced. Other significant female poets include Elizabeth Browning and Christina Rossetti. The sonnet was a popular form in Victorian poetry, notably in the work of Christina Rossetti, Gabriel Rossetti, and Elizabeth Barrett Browning. Christina Rossetti was one among the few women poets of the 19th century who united so fully the two main and usually distinct movements of the period: the poetry with the Pre-Raphaelite decor and the poetry of religious sensibility. In some ways, she could be viewed as a more typical Victorian poet. Her poetry reflected her deep Anglican faith and frequently pursued themes such as love and faith. Rossetti was a devoted Christian and spent a lot of time and energy as a member of the Church of England. Her work consistently conveyed her deep religious sensitivities and pervaded through most of her verse. However, this did not lead to preaching or moralizing front. Neither did she seek to deal with the incredible intellectual and theological difficulties arising from faith in general. Hers was the attitude of a worshipper, plain and simple. The awe and delight she found in God was to become evident as her work progressed. Christina Rossetti has often been compared to fellow female poet Elizabeth Barrett Browning. The work of Elizabeth Browning and Christina Rossetti is reassessed and given surprising and innovative literary, political, and intellectual contexts that will change the way we interpret their poetry. Christina Rossetti stands out among female poets of the Victorian era just because she was able to assert herself as a female poet as well as a critic of others' work. She also stood out as a superior poet amongst the members of the Pre-Raphaelite Brotherhood. Although she was not an official member of the Pre-Raphaelite Brotherhood, she was very much part of the movement. The Pre-Raphaelite movement was a resurgence of the Romantic spirit in a diluted form. The Pre-Raphaelite Brotherhood was first established as an association of painters in the year 1848 by its leader, Gabriel Rossetti. As poets, the Pre-Raphaelites had derived from Keats in their exclusive devotion to beauty. Like Keats, they rebelled against the scientific spirit and sought to exalt the love of physical beauty to the height of a cult. She shared with her brother the love and gift of art. It was she whom Gabriel Rossetti took to be his model and immortalized it in his Pre-Raphaelite idea of beauty, which was later followed by his successors. Rossetti found focus and relief in her devotional writing, and through her writing, she was able to find an appropriate outlet for her voice. Her desire for Christ and heaven helped her to find a new sense of purpose in her life. Christina Rossetti belonged to a group called the Tractarians, who believe that England was in need of spiritual revival and the church in need of reform, particularly with regard to the clergy. Tractarianism, or the Oxford movement, was an affiliation of high church Anglicans who wanted to reinvigorate the church by aligning it with a model of church created in the first few centuries following Christ's crucifixion and ascension. Christina Rossetti's poetic talent flourished at a time when there were two main prevalent tendencies, namely the Oxford movement and the Pre-Raphaelite movement. Of these two influences, Pre-Raphaelitism was by far the most powerful so far as her poetry is concerned, whereas the Oxford movement had the greater effect upon her life and character. Both in art and literature, it was a time of positive movement and great productivity. She had sincerely welcomed these prevailing influences of the new age and incorporated them in her works. Under the pen name Ellen Aline, she contributed to the literary magazine The Germ, published by the Pre-Raphaelites from January to April 1850 and edited by her brother William. This marked the beginning of her public career. Her first volume of poetry was Goblin Market, in which she provides a female voice on the subject of religion and offers commentary on the position of women in a male-driven economy, showing strange, melancholic things along with a lyrical talent. Goblin Market is a powerful indictment of Victorian commercialism. The poet equates trading with evil and contrasts it with a charming picture of rural activities untainted by money and exploitation of women. Rossetti wrote many excellent poems, such as Remember, which is a sonnet that reflects her beliefs on love, death, and remembrance. Other volumes of poetry included The Princess Progress, A Pageant, Sing Song, and Speaking Likeness. Much of her work was influenced by her deep religious beliefs. The publication of Goblin Market and other poems shows how naturally and how well she practiced a Pre-Raphaelite art without surrendering her originality. She is also a super artist in words, and the greatest of her qualities as a poet lies in the fact that she is extremely natural and spontaneous. Uphill is about the journey of life or death to heaven. The poem is an exchange of series of a brief and succinct questions and answers between two speakers. The entire poem is set in a dialogic form in which two travelers discuss about their uphill journey, symbolically suggesting the tiresome journey of life. The structure of the poem is arranged as a dialogue between an anxious traveler and a calm responder. One is quite near to death and he is frightened, while the other appears composed because he has experienced death and he is trying to ease the seeker's anxiety. So the title here indicates approaching heaven. The inn, situated at the end of the journey, is obviously a state of rest where the tired travelers will take refuge, being traveled, sore and weak. Throughout her poetry, Rossetti draws on the imagery of flames, mountains, stairs and hills to emphasize the upward progression of spiritual journey. She suggests that the journey to heaven is one of continuous upward movement, in that the soul is moved upwards away from the earth and its pleasures as it learns more of God and of heaven. In Uphill, Rossetti emphasizes the idea that the upward progression of the soul is not a simple and an easy process. Lots of distractions, concerns, and doubts can weigh a person down, and the upward movement can turn into one of struggle instead of one of joy. In Uphill, the Pre-Raphaelite poet, Rossetti, has dealt with the theme of life, death, and life after death. Deviating from the Christian doctrine of heaven and hell, Rossetti offers a simple and a laudable philosophy according to which everyone will get rest posthumously in proportion to one's earthly labor. The theme of this poem is that death is a way to leave for another world where we can find peace and comfort. So it is not terrible. Using this poem, Rossetti is addressing her readers on an optimistic note that while life is hard and ever-changing, that there is a reward in the end. this comes from her deeply religious roots, she also seems to portray the person answering each question as either God or Jesus. Christina Rossetti was brought up in a very religious family. She herself is very religious and avid Anglican. This religious influence is a great factor in this poem, which explains life and heaven. Poem is a dialogue between two people, which is paralleled with life. In this poem, the narrator seems to be two different people. The first narrator asking questions is just an ordinary person with questions that most people have. The second narrator seems to be a higher being answering the questions by the first narrator. The poem consists of four stanzas in which an individual is posing questions in the first and the third line of each stanza, and in the second and fourth lines of the stanza, someone is responding to those questions. The first stanza says that the road uphill is to wind all the way to the very end. Here, the road is like a life's journey. If one wants to seek heaven, one shall encounter some obstacles or troubles on the way, and in the end, which means death, one will find it. Morn symbolizes the sun and life, while night implies dark and death. One shall pursue for heaven from the time one is born till one dies. The poet is also telling us that our lifetime is just like a day's journey. It is so short that we should cherish it and make good use of it. In the second stanza, a resting place for the night indicates death also, because when one is dead, he is usually said as in deep sleep. And heaven here is described as an inn where one can spend his slow hark hours. In the third stanza, there are also other travelers on the way, which implies that on the way to eternity, one is not alone and one finds company all the way. And the door of the heaven is always open to those who have experienced so much on the way there, so one doesn't have to stand outside and wait. In the fourth stanza, after one finishes his service and behaves well, he will have a comfortable place to rest, that is death. Beds for all who come. Beds stand for death or can be interpreted as heaven. Every stanza begins with a question and ends with its answer. It seems that every question about death has an answer, so one does not have to worry about that. And there are many phrases indicating that death is not terrible at all. For examples, of labor you shall find the sum, and beds for all who come tells us that if one finishes labor and do good things when he is alive, he can have a good ending of his life. And all men are equal in the sight of God, so none of them will be ignored. It's a traditional poem with mixed meter. The meter used in this poem gives the reader a feeling of pacing steps as if they were climbing uphill. The poem contains four stanzas with four lines each. In each stanza, two questions are asked and two answers are given. Each stanza has its own individual rhyme scheme, that is ABAB. Also, this poem uses, I am stressing, rules, but it changes syllable usage. The poet uses imagery and symbolism to express emotion and picture a traveler who has to take the road uphill and who hopes to find an inn at the end of her travel. The tone of this poem is unique. It is a tone of determination. This comes from the fact that the road may always be uphill, but there is always a light at the end of the tunnel. In the poem Uphill, the poet uses allegory, which is when various symbols work together in a set pattern. The various symbols portrayed by Rossetti are consistent with those of a journey. A road, an inn, a resting place at night, and other wayfarers. Christina, in this poem, describes life and death in a symbolic way through asking questions and answering them. There are two speakers in the poem, one asking about the way uphill, the apprehensive traveler, and the other answering could be regarded as one who has experienced death. The poem Uphill is a lyric form. Symbolism is used by many poets to portray a message that is not exactly written. Christina Rossetti uses symbolism throughout the whole poem. She uses the element of symbolism to ask people's most difficult questions, and with every other line answers these questions in a way that gives the readers hope about life after death. In Uphill, the road symbolizes the journey. The speaker takes the inn, represents security. The door symbolizes admittance, and the beds indicate comfort and shelter. The road, instead of being straight, is winding, and uphill suggests that the path is long and difficult. However, that there is actually a road leading up the hill indicates that plenty of others have already taken the route that is being contemplated. The speaker will not have to carve or find her own path, since it has already been revealed to her. In the traveler is told that she cannot miss the inn, which stands at the top of the hill and offers rest for those who have spent the entire day climbing. Literally, the fact that it stands out in the darkness of the night indicates that the light that it sheds is powerful and will not be overpowered. Metaphorically, the inn represents security. The door. The traveler asks whether one will have to knock the door of the inn when one reaches it, or whether one will be kept waiting for admittance. One is reassured that the door will be opened upon arrival, and that those who have gone before will be ready to greet him or her. Beds. The traveler is promised beds for all who come to the inn. Rossetti employs imagery throughout the poem, implying that death is a welcome refuge after a long, hard journey. It is the world that is to be feared and turned from in the end. Death will provide a roof and an inn, and there we will find a welcome by those who have gone before. Life, Rossetti tells us, is a long journey, lasting from morn to night, and death is not an end to be feared, but a rest to be earned and welcomed. The juxtaposition of fatalism and optimism fascinates. The image of beds indicates rest, comfort, and shelter, security. After a long struggle, the idea of resting is all the speaker can look forward to. This symbolizes that there is a room in heaven for all who come, and there is a resting place for all people who seek it. Christina Rossetti was recognized as a major Victorian poet and as the greatest women poet in the 19th century. In her best poetry, she emerges as a born poet. Her warm, sensuous images, sense of rhythm and phrasing, delicacy of feeling, and suggestions of another world all bespeak an original talent which has no rival in its limited territory. Death and devotion dominate her poetry, and in both she finds satisfaction of her erotic urges, ways to survive in a harsh world. Like William Blake, she was able to overturn the complicated and bring them into simple light for readers to grasp, and this was partly what made her so popular. Few poets have been able to convey with equal clarity the reality of things unseen and unheard by the ordinary senses as well as Rossetti and William Blake. Her poetry is characterized by imaginative power, exquisite expression, and simplicity and depth of thought. She rarely imitated any forerunner and drew her inspiration from her own experiences of thought and feeling. Her poetic genius is quite spontaneous, and her emotion, both secular and religious, is ardent and genuine. Her poems are primarily concerned with a subject after her own heart, death and religion. No English poet has laid bare personal emotion more clearly and sincerely than Christina has done in the best of her lyrics. Rossetti's work focused a great deal on death and the futility of life. Yet, whilst one may expect to find her poems unbearably sad and depressing, there was a certain charm to her writing, with her subtle feeling of beauty and her almost childlike sense of innocent wonder that balanced out the melancholy. She accepted the pain and sadness in her life as she found, and did not seek to justify the ways of God to mankind. As a poet, Christina Rossetti's works painted such vivid and complex pictures that inspired many questions, thus explaining why her poetry into our modern day being reimagined and reinterpreted. Her genius took command of her and made her write poems which her conscious self would have repudiated as false record of her feelings, but which nonetheless reflected her true self. Thus, it can be seen that Rossetti, despite certain close affinities with the romantic and religious poets on the one hand and with the Pre-Raphaelites on the other, passed beyond them. That is why her work has a timeless quality about it. To conclude, the poem Uphill is paralleled with life. It explains life as a journey and life's unavoidable death. This poem conveys a message: while life is hard and ever-changing, there is a reward in the end. The entire poem reads like a conversation regarding an uphill journey, but underneath the so-called simple form lies a deeper meaning referring to the ultimate destination of every human being. Hope you enjoyed our today's program. Thank you. We'll see you soon.